Turning our attention now to the ASX. Here's Matt Birney and Bulls and Bears with the latest public company views and interviews.
Welcome to Bulls and Bears, brought to you today by 4DS Memory, ASX code 4DS. I'm Matt Birney and I'm joined now by the Executive Chairman of 4DS Memory, David McAuliffe. Hi, Dave.
Morning, mate.
Okay, so 4DS Memory is on a mission to create a new class of memory that has the potential to shake up the semiconductor chip market. The company has two strategic partnerships, one with the world's number one independent semiconductor Institute Imec, and another with a subsidiary of one of the world's largest digital storage players, Western Digital Corporation. After a challenging year of R&D, 4DS recently nailed its latest round of testing that saw its share price hike sevenfold. Okay, Dave, we'll get into those test results in a moment, but firstly, what problem are you trying to solve here? How does your computer memory differ to what's out there?
Well, it doesn't exist at the moment, Matt. So in your devices, you have a thing called DRAM and you have something called flash. And so both of those technologies have different characteristics. So what the industry is looking for is something which is a combination of both. They're looking for something which has really, really fast ability to read a cell or write to a cell, but also has the ability to retain the information when the power's off. So that doesn't exist at the moment. So the results we showed on our fourth platform lot give an indication that we're getting very close to being able to solve this problem. And it's an industry challenge, and there hasn't been a lot of change to how our devices work. And we potentially have something which will change the industry going forward.
Okay, so I see your share price ran from 3 to about 21 cents recently on the back of some successful testing. Without getting too scientific, what were the practical outcomes of that testing?
What it showed is that we're very close to the most significant piece of technology in your device. So it's called DRAM. So it has the ability to work, nanoseconds in terms of its ability to write to a cell in 30 nanoseconds. We've shown we're very close to that. It has the ability to turn on and off a cell a billion times. We've been able to show we can do our cell for 2 billion times. And we've also shown we've been able to retain information when the power's off. So we're looking like we could be a companion to DRAM, and this is what the industry is looking for. So, you know, the results are far better than we expected, and we're continuing to do more testing on our device going forward.
How much cash have you got? I'm guessing it's expensive to do this testing, right?
No, we're pretty lean. So we spend about $5 million a year, $4.55 million a year. So we reported in June we had $5.6 million. So I'm guessing we've probably got about 4.8 at the moment. But because of the way the share price has behaved, we've got a whole heap of options that are coming in. So we're fully funded for a couple of years now.
Very quickly, what's the business model look like? How do you commercialise this thing?
We're not in the business of doing licensing deals. We think that a licensing model doesn't work. So we're looking to get the technology proven up enough for it to be acquired by one of the major players in the area. So Imec, got everyone on their books in terms of partners. So, Imec will likely to be our business model in terms of introductions to all those different types of companies.
David McAuliffe from 4DS Memory, thanks for joining me on Bulls and Bears. And remember, we're only here to give you information, not advice, which you should, of course, seek independently. I'm Matt Birney, and this is Bulls and Bears.
For more public company interviews, go to the Money page on the 6PR, 2GB, 3AW and 4BC websites and click the Public Companies tab.